to the show. Something popped up in my inbox, and it's from, well, I don't know if it's from Dick's promoter or somebody who knows Dick's promoter, but he's complaining. Apparently, Dick's promoter is complaining that Jasmine used to be his girl. Not his girl, like his girl, but he used to be the girl he managed and made music with. But now, ever since she joined Team No Sleep, all that Bushington and everybody else in Team No Sleep is doing is just hitting it, hitting it, hitting it, and there's no music coming from there. Just recently, DJ Roger clarified on who is responsible for the pregnancy, and he says it's his baby Jasmine is carrying. I don't know if DJ Roger is part of Team No Sleep, but this doesn't make any sense. I mean, if you think that somebody in Team No Sleep is hitting it, and also if it's not Bushington and everybody in there hitting it, it's not their problem. I think she has made it available for hitting, for whoever wants to hit. So in my opinion, it's not Bushington or Breadken or anybody's fault. It's Jasmine. She has made herself available for hitting. My name is Mary Luswata, and welcome to the show. Well, there's a lot more to come. Somebody help me understand. What is Palaso still doing in Uganda? The last I checked, he came for a launch. A launch that was what? N months ago. So what is he still doing here? He's getting into beef and, you know, producing beef songs. And that's, it's clearly not what we need right now. We need some inspiration and not about Tamale Mirundi. And now I hear there's a new one from him hitting at Weasel called Jawe Mbaliga. Weasel in Mbaliga. I don't know. But Weasel must have something really wrong. And I need to look at Weasel. And I think I need to screen him naked and see all his flaws, because it looks like he has lots of hair. Here I was making noise about the numerous pimples on his face, and now there is Mbaliga. Like, honestly, I think they can correct things like that. Ah, that Weasel is too old to have his Mbaliga corrected. Now the problem is, if Weasel has Mbaliga and then he meets up with a chick who has, there will be the kids will just be what. Anyway, Mbu, according to Palaso, and Palaso is Weasel's big brother, so clearly Palaso knows Weasel more than all of us do. So Weasel, oline Mbaliga obaneda. I wish I could call you and clarify on that, but what would you say? Nine Mbaliga? I don't think so. I don't know if you guys have heard, but this is even a shaming for me to say. Here I was on the show, I mean, hitting back at Judith Hurd for taking selfies at a vigil, and at Sylvia Worry for hanging on to Juliana like she's a handbag, and for everybody else who took advantage of Juliana's loss. I had not come across this chick from, oh wait, she's still in Eagles, where the new Eagles, where Diamond Production, I don't know. But anyway, what's her name? Maureen Nantumi. She decides when she was going to South Africa, just this last week, by the way, she gets pictures of the pictures that were making rounds on social media, Karen's pictures with his mother, with his father, his pictures, and then she sort of, I don't even know what to say about this, because it's very ashamed, especially for a woman who has kids, and it's very easy for you to lose this child. So anyway, she makes CDs of Juliana's music, but she backs the whole thing up with pictures, so she's gonna make some quick money in South Africa. You know how people stay out of this country for so long and they want to know about home, they want news about home. That's one of the reasons why Scoop on Scoop is such a big deal on YouTube, because these guys are dying to know what is going on at home. So Maureen Nantume takes advantage of that, and she decides she's gonna go to South Africa and sell these CDs. Like, honestly, eh? I mean, even among them, I can't find somebody who could stoop that low. But you, Maureen Nantume, you decided to go and make money out of Juliana's loss? I don't even have words for you. I don't have words for you. All I can say is things like that. Eh? You can, in fact, if you're this chick's over boyfriend, over husband, first of all, I'm feeling sorry. Oh, I know somebody who can do something like that. Sylvia Worry. Because you remember the time when they were having custody battles with Seya, and she said, me, if you give me 800 million, I can give you this boy, because that's... I feel like Sylvia can do that. But Worry Nantume, I'm still in shock, by the way. That's why I don't even have the words to say about this. Oh, this, you know, I told you guys that when Zari pops up in the country, there will be news for me. In fact, the day I heard that she had returned, I was like, oh, finally, somebody's going to make news. And she's been around for, what, 2 days? And already there's news about Zari. So, besides her parading her boo, apparently she has traveled back to South Africa because Ivan is stalking her. Now, I don't get this. Honestly, this... this nonsense, honestly, sometimes it gets here and I just feel like I want to puke at some of these things. Ivan is stalking his wife. I don't get it. Apparently, we hear the man paid what? 100 cows for her. And when he asks her to come back home, now she feels like she's being stalked. In fact, she has to go back. She has to get onto a plane and travel back to South Africa because she's been stalked. You see, that's why I tell you, Ivan, this nonsense light, but not necessarily bright. Anyway, for some men, they prefer their women dumb because it's a very easy way to handle them. I mean, there's really no intellectual challenge. I don't feel any intellectual challenge coming from Zari. Honestly, every time I read her tweets, they're like, Googled Maya Angelou. And you see, the problem with these people is that they don't even have the nerve or the courtesy to acknowledge where these quotes or Zari will make it seem like it's her quotes. I mean, everything you read, Zari and Judith Hurd, their damn highnesses, they just go to Google, find a quote, and then make it look like it's there. So, Farouk, you need to become like a real handbag so that every time they travel out of the country, they don't leave you here. Because usually when Zari is running away, she leaves you here. Then when she comes back, she remembers that you two are dating. Clearly, for me, I feel like you're just being used, but don't take my words. Everybody thinks I'm a hater. In fact, Zari the other day told me, doll, get laid. These old women. And it's a wrap, guys. I really wanted to show you some of what goes on behind the scenes when we are filming this show. But my producer is like, no, it's not yet time. We'll do it some other time, maybe Monday. So anyway, you guys can look forward to that. And of course, my fantastic makeup artist, Fiona Shirabo, says, what's up to all ya? And she wants to know if you have any events coming up so you can, you know, holla, and she can, you know, sort you out. Oh, she's got all your makeup needs covered. So weddings, I know there'll be lots of them this weekend. I know there'll be parties. I know there'll be quandulas. I know there'll be all sorts of functions. So get in touch with Fiona. Her Facebook is F-Y-O-N-A, Fiona Kirabo. That's her Twitter as well, her Instagram too. So you have so many ways to get in touch with her. Make sure you look fab this weekend. And I love you all. Mwah! Take care of yourselves. Make sure you don't drink and drive and use a condom. I'll see you back on Monday. Ciao.